everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in the myself Alfia Qureshi. So in the last video we completed elbow joint. Now in this video we'll be discussing about the carrying angle, which is also a topic of elbow joint. Okay, so we'll be discussing about the carrying angle. So what is the carrying angle? Basically, it is a angle between the vertical axis of your arm and forearm. So your forearm is not completely straight in a vertical line. It is slightly tilted outwards because its axis of your elbow joint is directed medially downwards. Okay, like this. It is not like this. It is medially downward. That's why your arm is in straight line, but your forearm is tilted outwardly. So the angle between the axis of your arm and forearm is known as the carrying angle. Okay. Definition is angle between long axis of arm and forearm is carrying angle. Why it is so? The basic reason is that when you walk, while walking or running, your hand do not stuck to your hip region. That's why your arms are tilted outwards, slightly outwards. And which factors are responsible for making this carrying angle? So the factors are the medial flange of trochlea is deeper than lateral one, okay? 6 millimeter deeper, okay? So the medial flange of your trochlea, so this is the trochlea, this capitulum, this is trochlea. So this is the trochlea. So this medial flange of your trochlea is deeper as compared to this lateral flange. That's why this medial side of your ulna bone gets more deeper. So it is oblique. That's why your arm is like this and arm is like this and forearm is like this, okay? Obviously, if something is not straight, it is oblique, or a part is more deeper and a part is vertical, it is not in a straight line. And the second point is that the upper surface of coronoid process of ulna is also oblique. So your upper articular surface is also oblique and lower articular surface is also oblique. So that's why it makes the horizontal axis of your elbow oblique, not straight. So this is the main reason. These are the main factors of formation of carrying angle. Okay, so the upper surface of coronoid process of ulna is also oblique. Okay, so this angle is 14 degree in females and 11 degree in males. Okay, now there are some abnormalities regarding this angle. So if this angle is less, or your arm is more towards this side, it is known as cubitus varus. And if the angle is more and your arm is more towards the outer side, it is known as cubitus valgus. So there are two abnormalities. One is cubitus वेरस, सेकेंड इज क्यूबाइटस वल्गस. ओके, इन दिस द एंगल इज लेस, इन दिस द एंगल इज मोर. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कैरिंग एंगल. होप यू गाइस अंडरस्टूड द टॉपिक. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share this video with your friends, don't forget to subscribe the channel and also press the bell icon. Thanks for watching this video.